Yeah, Monty. Last year, you beat Auburn, but you were one upset guy in the locker room that they scored a rushing touchdown. This year, obviously, you guys kept Auburn out of the end zone. I mean, can you just talk about that as a goal and just trying to keep the guys motivated against Auburn and making sure they didn't get in the end zone again on you?
You know, this game been played for what, 130 years. You know, it's easy to be motivated for it. You know, they got a lot of people over there that's, you know, from here or wanting to go here or, you know, deciding if, like, between the two. So, you know, it's always good to not let somebody run it in, and if they want to score, they got to throw it because, you know, I feel like that's – it's easy to just, you know, run it on somebody and score. North and south is the quickest way to the end zone. So, you know, that just goes to show how, you know, our practice is paying off and the things that we work on each and every day, Monday to Thursday.
Connor Riley, do you have a question?
No, I do not.
Okay, we'll go to Austin Roper.
Hey, can you just grade how you think the secondary did tonight? You know, I mean, they had some pretty big receivers to go up against with Seth Williams and Anthony Schwartz. You know, and for much of the game they were without Richard LeCount. How much was that? Was their performance to you? How would you grade that?
I mean, they played great. You know, you had one or two pass interferences, but, you know, those were aggressive penalties, and, you know, we'll take those. But, you know, they did a phenomenal job executing the game plan that our coaches put in play for us.
Okay, next we'll go to Jed May.
Hey, Monty, I just wanted to know, when you face an offense like Auburn, you know, how much of an emphasis is – you know, taking away the option of the quarterback on those design runs, and how well do you think you fared in that aspect of the game tonight?
I think, you know, obviously it's Bo Nix. He's a great athlete, but for the most part, we did a good job. You know, there's a couple plays we didn't finish on them in the backfield, but, you know, that's why you got to swarm, you know, in bunches, you know, five, six guys on the ball, you know, and that's going to make up for any, like, missed tackles or, you know, with a guy like Bo Nix. So, you know, that just goes to how we practice during the week.
And Dennis, do you have a question?
Yeah, Monty, of course you and Richard been in the program a long time, but when he goes down, what do you say to people, you know, within the defensive huddle there, and how do y'all kind of rally around, you know, him going out the way he did?
I mean, y'all saw it. We all saw it. I think it was the best way he could have tackled him without targeting. Obviously, they called it, but, you know, you can't – that was textbook the way he, you know, played it, in my opinion. I'm glad it happened in the first half because we're going to need him next week against Tennessee. But, you know, we just – you know, we always together. So, you know, it ain't a big deal. You know, next man up, Chris Smith, came in and played well. So, you know, we got guys.
Homer Jones, do you have a question?
Yeah, Monty. Coach Lanning kind of said last year that y'all were the no-name defense. Y'all gave up 39 yards on the ground tonight. What do you think the identity of this defense is?
Relentless, tough, physical, and, you know, we've earned, you know, those couple of trademarks, but we got to, you know, go out and show that each and every week, because you can't just say you something you're not if you ain't doing it. Actions louder than words.
Okay, and we will open it up for a few more questions for Monty.
Monty, can you just talk about the atmosphere? Was it different? I mean, did the crowds did they kind of, you know, still bring it with I guess a limited capacity?
I mean, there was a few players out there I couldn't even hear, so I don't know if that was artificial or them, but it was some was loud, but no, it was still a great atmosphere. I think the fans did well tonight. They showed up and showed out.
Two more questions for Monty.
Monty, can you talk about practice last week? I know, you know, Kirby said it was business as usual, but it ultimately comes down to you players and team leaders, and you're kind of looked at as a leader on the defense. Was anything said? Was there any emphasis made on making sure this defense was dialed in tonight and making sure you guys were ready for Auburn?
Yeah, my biggest thing I feel like we need to work on is communication, not getting lazy with the calls, and, you know, just making sure everybody on the same page. And I know there's one time in the game where we had to – one of the DBs signaling something wasn't, and we was wrong, but at least we were, you know, we were rolling together on the same page, and that's what it's all about, making sure, like, hey, if it's devil and we supposed to play cover seven, then, you know, we all play cover seven. So, you know, we just got to just keep communicating and playing as a team.
Last question. Okay, thank you, Monty.